And this song is called Radio. But what really is, it's really about freedom. It's about the value of unbiased news, the importance of culture without censorship. And it takes us, Germans, back to the days of the communist regime in the East. A bit over 30 years ago, if you have lived about 5 kilometers from here, listening to Western media could have cost you your career. For people living under the East German dictatorship, the Funkturm, the broadcasting tower here at our exhibition halls, was the main source for real news and great music. Today, of course, most people get their news from small devices that we can carry around in our packets. And once again, IFA is at the forefront of this, of showcasing this technology. I wanted to play you this song today because we live in a world where we all struggle to tell the difference between real news and fake news. This Rammstein song is a reminder of the importance of good journalism and that media shape their societies. Thank you. But now, a big welcome to IFA 2019. We just had what seemed like an endless summer here, or in the United States, of course, the Labor Day weekend. So I hope you are all well rested and ready for an amazing 6 days ahead. Once again, IFA, we are fully booked. Not just here at our halls, but also at IFA Global Markets in the heart of the city, at Station Berlin. What awaits you is a carefully created trade show with the latest and the greatest across consumer electronics and home appliances. We are a platform for our industry's top brands from around the world. At IFA, we really have just two objectives. Showcase the best of what's new in our industry and bring the best minds and ideas together to make co-innovation happen. Co-innovation? You may have heard me say it before. Co-innovation is when people from different industries, companies, and nations bring their own approach and thinking to a problem and inspire each other to solve it. But co-innovation is not easy. It works best when there's a free flow of ideas and products can be moved without any barriers. In today's world of global innovation and integrated supply chains, the only way to build the best possible device is by having the freedom to choose the best ideas, components, and software, wherever they're from. But indeed, it shows this is getting more and more difficult. And I'm not going to tell you who's right or who's wrong in all the trade wars around the world. I leave it to you to be the judge. But let me remind you, trade is not a zero-sum game. And when it comes to innovation, any barrier, whatever that's tariffs otherwise, is harmful. It harms consumers because what they buy costs more. And because what they can buy will not be the best product, because it cannot be using the best components in the world. And this, of course, harms economies, because so many things will have to be innovated twice. It's a setback for innovation itself, because it will make co-innovation so much more difficult. And here's the good news. We're not there yet. The amazing products here at IFA 2019 are a testament to that. But we should always bear in mind that it's the power of innovation that is making everybody in every country in the world healthier, safer, and better off. As always, IFA is teeming with innovation, so let me pick just a couple of trends. One, voice. Now, this isn't new anymore, I know. What's new is that voice is not a novelty, but rapidly becoming a standard user interface. Second, artificial intelligence, or AI. This is really coming into its own. but it will not always be very obvious. At its best, it will be completely hidden from us. It will just do its job by connecting devices and services, by knowing in advance our needs and wants, by making our lives easier. AI has already started to transform the world. And three, of course, 5G connectivity. Today we are seeing only the beginnings of what the new generation of mobile networks can do. But its promise is unrivaled. By the way, did you notice that we don't speak much about the Internet of Things anymore? That's because it's already happening. It's the new normal, powered by connectivity, AI and voice. And I'm certain, just a few years from now, at IFA 2025, it's a promise, these three technologies will have completely transformed every single device that you will see in our halls today. Driving this kind of change is one of the most innovative companies in the world. Its research department and its investment in R&D are as huge as its ambitions. I'm speaking, of course, about Huawei. Now I see our grand theater here at IFA Next is packed to the rafters. And it's no surprise, because Huawei has been a bit in the news lately. This may well be one of the most anticipated IFA keynotes for years. At IFA, we always want to show you the best. And that's why this morning we have invited Huawei at our keynote stage. This afternoon at 2 p.m., you will hear from another global leader in 5G and edge computing, Qualcomm. When it comes to consuming content, streaming is the new black. And that's why on Saturday, tomorrow, we have one of the industry's big disruptors on this stage here, Roku at 10:30 a.m., followed at 2 p.m. by Archer Lake, a company that's driving the digital transformation of the home. But first, Huawei. It's a company geared for disruption. Many of you may know the book by Nassim Taleb, The Black Swan. It explores how we can deal with the impact of extreme and highly improbable events. He calls these events black swans. After the arrival of the first black swans in Europe in ancient days, which gave everyone who saw them a real shock. Now, this picture behind me, it's of a black swan. Definitely. I took it myself. Sorry for the quality. I took it myself at the Huawei R&D campus in Shenzhen. Huawei is keeping these black swans on a lake in the middle of their campus. To their researchers, it's a constant reminder to think of the improbable and to prepare for it. So, let's hear it from the man in charge. Getting IFA 2019 underway. Here's Richard Yu, the chief executive of Huawei Consumer Business Group. The stage is yours, Richard.
Hey. Hi. Thank you, Jens.
Thank you.
Thank you give Huawei the opportunity. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. So big pleasure back to Berlin again, and every year we're here in IFA, and we launched a new product. Today I will bring the two new chipsets and three products here. We launched it here. Do you remember that 2 years ago in IFA, we launched the Huawei Kirin 970 chipset? That's the first flagship smartphone chips which have the AI processor inside. We're introducing the NPU, the neural network process, in the smartphone chipset, the Kirin 970. And last year, here in IFA, we launched Kirin 980. It's the first smartphone premium high-end chipset which have the dual AI processor, dual NPU inside. We are leading the mobile AI in the world. You know, that I remember that time when we launched the smartphone which have AI processor inside, many people ask me, including many media, they ask me, how can you use AI? What's the usage? So 2 years passed. Can you see there's more and more apps they are using AI, and including the mobile photography, including the many, many things, including the traveling, the online shopping, education, the creation, the art creation, many, many things. More and more apps, they are using AI. And you see that last 2 years, just on Huawei flagship smartphone, the AI API was accessed over 1.6 trillion times. Can you imagine that's so rapid growth? Every year, every month, every day, it's increasing rapidly. So today, if you design app that you are not using AI, the functionality, that will be the, it will dramatically influence your performance. So AI can do more and more things, the AI. You know, that's 2 years ago when we launched the Kirin 970 here in IFA, we bring the idea of a mobile AI. That time is a mobile AI, we call it 1.0. That's the on-device AI and the cloud AI together. Today, you know, the 5G is coming. Today with 5G, I'm sorry, I am back to you. Today on the 5G, with 5G and we upgrade our mobile AI to 2.0. And what's the mobile AI 2.0? You know the mobile AI 1.0, that's we have the real-time on-device AI processing. But with the 4G, the limited speed and the limited latency, so we only have semi-real-time on-cloud inference, on-cloud AI processing. So, but today, on the AI 2.0 with 5G, the 5G have much fast speed, much lower latency, so we can achieve real-time on-cloud AI processing also. So the real-time on-device AI and on-cloud AI together, so we bring to the mobile AI 2.0. You know, last year we launched the first 5G modem, the single mode modem, the 5G01. That's last year. But in the beginning of this year, we launched the first the multi-mode modem, the Balong 5000, in the beginning of this year. But today, I bring the new solution. Oh, yeah. Today, you know, today the industry, you know, if you see the country we are using, that's the 4G SoC modem chips together with the 5G modem together. They combine together the solution. If the industry, the other vendors, they're all using this. But Huawei, the product we already launched, is the Kirin 980 together with the Balloon 5000. We can support the multi-mode, the NSA and the SA architecture both. Today, the other solution is only can support the NSA architecture. What's the NSA? It's a non-standalone architecture. In the 5G, in the beginning, the rollout, the network is using NSA architecture. But the 5G future should be SA architecture, the standalone architecture. But we're proud of the Balloon 5000 together with the Kirin 980. That's we can support the multi-mode. Not only multi-mode, but also dual architecture. The currently NSA architecture for 5G, but also the future SA architecture. This is the best 5G solution today, up to now. But today I bring the new one, the new generation. It's the world's first 5G SoC, the revolutionary 5G SoC in the here. It's a Kirin 990. It's so small, tiny size. It's smaller than my nail size. But can you believe that? How many transistors on it? Over 10 billion transistors on it. 10.3 billion transistors on it. It's the world's first. Thank you. It's the world's most powerful 5G SoC chipset. It's inside this have octa-core CPU, the 16-core powerful GPU inside, and also the most advanced ISP, and also most advanced AI processor inside. But more importantly, it's what the most powerful 5G modem inside this. It supports both SA and NSA architecture. We bring a revolutionary leap in 5G and AI. The Kirin 990 5G, you know, we bring the best performance on 5G, AI, and performance. Let's first look at 5G. You know, today the 5G, the company A, their 5G is not available yet, right, this year at least. And the other companies, their solution is a 4G SoC plus 5G modem. You know that some companies announced some 5G SoC modem, SoC chips, but actually it's a PPT chips. It's not available yet, at least in this year. Maybe they are only for the next year. But we, today these chips is already commercialized. So currently the solution is the 4G SoC and 5G modem together. But the Kirin 990 5G is the first all-in-one 5G chipset. We call SoC system on chip. It's using the world's most advanced 7 nanometer FinFET plus EUV. This is the latest semiconductor technology. You see that compared with others, you can see the first and also the only flagship 5G SoC all in one. And also by the only one chip solution compared with the other two chips together, so we're saving more PCB board space, making more size, more compact. The board area can be 36% smaller. That can leave more space for you to install more large battery for your smartphone or make your phone more compact. And on this chipset, over 10 billion transistors on it. Oh, the screen not work. Okay. 10.3 billion transistor on it. Do you remember last year on the Kirin 980? It has 6.9 billion transistors on that Kirin 980. But today, on the Kirin 990 5G, we have over 10 billion transistors on it. And also with 5G, you can achieve the lightning super fast 5G speed. On the new radio, the new radio, the download maximum can achieve 2.3 gigabit per second. How fast it is? Let's see that on the China Mobile's real network test, on real commercial network, you can reach the more than 1.7 gigabit per second. See that? How fast it is? You will download near 2 gigabyte the video, the apps. You can see this in just several seconds doing that. It's much faster than the 4G. And also music download, you can see how fast. Suddenly, immediately. You download a HD movie, it's just several seconds. You can download that. It's unbelievable speed. It's really super fast. And today the challenge for 5G firstly I think it will be the weak signal. Why the weak signal? Because in the beginning the limited radio base station size, the limited coverage, and also the 5G is running more higher frequency. So indoor penetration also the issues. So you always miss the weak signal in the beginning of the 5G rollout. And also the power consumption issue for the 5G. And also speed, especially on high speed moving, how can we guarantee that you have 5G, super fast speed 5G? So how can we solve these kind of issues? We bring our solution, the smart uplink speed, to conquer the weak signal. If you are in the weak 5G signal area, that you have a good 4G connection, you can combine these two together. So combine the 4G and 5G uplink, we can achieve sometime in some area we can achieve 5.8 times faster speed in the weak 5G signal area. And also, we have the to save the energy. Sometimes you don't need so fast speed you transmit. But we introducing the BWP, the bandwidth part. Well, with the bandwidth part on, you don't need so large bandwidth, and you can network with, then you can saving the power consumption. You can see that with BWP on, bandwidth part on, you can saving 15% of the power consumption. Compared with the other chipset, we can saving 44% less power consumption. So less power consumption is very critical for 5G. So we have the solution for this to saving the energy. If you're in a full speed of the 5G, we still can achieve the 20% better efficiency. You can see the comparison with other modem of solution. You can see the 20% less power consumption with a full speed running. And also we have the, for the fast moving, when in a fast speed car or railway, over 120 kilometers per hour, the fast speed, we still can achieve high speed by our new technology, by our additional beamforming gain technology. Machine learning based on the channel model, it's advanced adaptive receiver to secure the 5G speed on high speed move. And also, this chipset, the Kirin 990, we support the advanced dual SIM card. We not only support a dual SIM card, a dual voltage, but when one phone is making phone call, another SIM card can accept, can receive the voltage phone call coming. Also, we can support one SIM card either in a voltage phone call, another SIM card, we can using the 5G data simultaneously. The other phone, other chipset, they cannot support this. So this brings us the leading performance on dual SIM card. And also, the more importantly, this Kirin 990 5G is not designed not only for today, the 5G, but also for future. The future of the 5G network should be SA architecture, standalone architecture. Standard SA architecture have better performance, lower latency, so we support this chipset is not only for today, but also for future. You know, today, the 5G, we not only the Kirin 990, not only bring the best 5G, but also bring the best AI. You will see that from the last in every generation, we are leading the AI performance. You can see on Kirin 970, the 2 years ago, up to last year, Kirin 980, we are all leading the AI performance. Today on the Kirin 990 5G, we have over 3 times higher AI performance compared with the industry, the other vendors. We are leading on AI performance. If you see the last 2 years, ourselves, we have 12 times AI performance enhancement in last 2 years. You know that we not only provide the best, the most powerful AI processing capability, but also bring the best energy efficiency. If you see that on the mobile net is a light mode, the light mode comparison, and our performance is much better than the others. But even in the, on the heavy load, we also our performance, the ResNet 50, is a heavy load model, we still have much better performance. But more importantly, the energy efficiency, no matter in light mode or heavy mode, we all achieved much stronger energy efficiency, even up to 8 times more better efficiency. I think the energy efficiency is the key, is more important. Because of phones, the power efficiency, always phones' battery life is always the biggest issue. And more importantly, you know, if you use less apps using the, fully using AI capability, they need more AI operator support. We support over 300 AI operators, but the other only can support 100 level, so 3 times higher. With more AI operators, it can let the apps fully use the AI capability. And also, we can support multi-standard of AI. The high AI is a Huawei AI standard, AI platform. But we also support the Facebook TensorFlow AI platform. And in the same time, we also support the Google's Android NN AI platform. So we can support the multi-platform AI. You know, that this time we're also introducing a very innovative the new architecture for the AI processing. We call it the big, tiny core combination architecture. But inside this is the big core, we are using the new generation, the world's first Da Vinci architecture, the most powerful AI processor in this world. By this, the big and the tiny combination, and bring the high performance, but also low power consumption. How can we achieve that? So we give an example that like a truck using the big truck to take the heavy load, the goods. But you only have big truck, you take small goods, you also need the big truck, the big waste. So, and more complex. But our solution, like this, the big call for the big traffic, for the big goods like the truck. And the small one, we're using a small truck. So we can achieve the best performing, lower power consumption, lower consumption. So we achieve the best efficiency. So by this technology, I give you an example for the using the AI for the face detection. For example, we can achieve the 24 times better efficiency, energy efficiency, compared with the others by this big core and little core together, big core and tiny core together. So really high efficiency. You know that on the Kirin 980, the AI processor, we can support single instance segmentation. But today, on this Kirin 990, we can support multi-instance segmentation. Let's see how it works. You can see on this video that we can, a group of people together, we can change the background, the real-time change the video, the background. And also we can kind of move some people away, or even can enlarge some people to make this group, the AI, the real-time processing. So this shows how strong AI processing power on these chips. You know, this Kirin 990 5G will not only bring the best 5G and AI also have the best performance. Let's see inside this. And then we have octa-core CPU, but we are in leading architecture. We call it the big, middle, and little architecture. Big, middle, and little. Two big core for high performance. Two middle core for medium performance, also for lower power consumption. And four little core for actual lower power consumption. This combination, you can see that with the big core, the performance improved compared with the industry, the other chips. So around 10% better performance, and also around near 10% of the energy efficiency for the multi, for the performance or multi-core performance. But more importantly, you know, the power efficiency is the key. Today, you know, the CPU, the performance, even more than the smartphones needed. But the more important is the energy efficiency. The energy efficiency, you know, is on middle core, we can achieve the near 35% improvement. That's a lot. And no matter in big core and little core and middle core, we all achieve the better energy efficiency by this combination together. we can always have the best energy efficiency. I think that's the most important than the CPU, the performance itself. The energy efficiency is the key. Today, on the Kirin 990, the 5G, we upgrade our GPU core from the 10 core to 16 core. The day before yesterday, I see the news. Some vendor they launched their new PBT 5G modem. Their core is just the 5 GPU core, but we have 16, more than 3 times. So we have achieved the best performance because the GPU is very important for today's mobile gaming. Many people, they are using the mobile phones and mobile gaming. But I think that the GPU, the graphic processing, the most important is not just the performance, but also more importantly, the energy efficiency, the power efficiency. So we achieved over 20% better energy efficiency compared with the industry, the others. The graphic processing, you can see it's 20% better on this. And also we're introducing smart cache between the CPU, GPU, and the NPU, the L2, L3 cache with the DDR. So with this, we can save 15% the bandwidth, but also power consumption can achieve the 20% lower. Now this is the mobile gaming, the very popular game. So you can see that we achieve the high frame rate, but also much lower power consumption. The red character, you can see that the power consumption is lower. So you can play the game more smoothly, but the power consumption is much lower than the others. You can see you can read the red character. You know, that's where in this chipset, we're also introducing the fifth generation ISP, the imaging signal processor. The imaging processor is mainly for the photo and the video. You know, that's for you taking photo in a low light condition and take a video in a low light condition, we can achieve the imaging noise reduction over 30% reduction. And you may take the video noise reduction also over 20% reduction on them. So it's very, very important. I assure you that on these chips, we're introducing the world's first BM3D. What's BM3D? It's a professional DSLR camera. They are using the imaging noise reduction technologies. Now we move to the Kirin 990. You can see that compared with the last generation, in the low light photography, you can see this wall ball, the fiber, the detail, you can see that very clearly. In a very low light environment, you take a photo. And also, in a low light, the video we're taking, you can see the noise. Compared with the last generation, you can see it's much less noise, the video noise. You know, with this powerful ISP capability and also powerful AI capability, we can do a lot of things. Like these girls, we use the camera to see this girl's face. We can recognize her real-time heartbeat and also her breath rate, heartbeat rate and breath rate. Every time your heart beats, you can read that from the camera. It's unbelievable. Because they're so strong processing power. By using your smartphone, you let the phone's camera see this girl, the heartbeat. Heartbeat rate, you can see that. You calculate your heart rate.
Health AR can also recognize your
even breath rate
and more.
So you can see that. We use this video just to show our strong capability of the processor. That makes something unbelievable things. Thank you. You know, this Kirin 990 5G, we also bring the 4G version for these chips. The main difference is this the modem. There's only this support 5G, another only support 2G, 3G, and 4G. And one is using a 7 nanometer, and others using 7 nanometer FinFET plus EUV. And the NPU core is 2B core and 1B core. But the NPU AI processor is have the leading performance already. It's the Kirin 990 and Kirin 990 5G. We have two for selection. So ladies and gentlemen, the Kirin 990 5G is the world's most powerful flagship 5G SoC. It's the world's first 5G SoC can support dual architecture, NSA and SA architecture, have the most powerful leading semiconductor technology, 7 nanometer FinFET plus EUV, and also have the most powerful GPU called 16 core Mali G76 GPU inside, and also the most powerful big tiny combination architecture NPU AI processor inside, and also the most powerful ISP inside. And Nomad on, you can hear the comparison with others. Nomad on 5G, on AI, on the dual SIM card capability, on the NPU, GPU, and all of that. You can see all the benchmark, we are leading the best performing SoC chipset. So Kirin 90 5G, leading the industry 5G, AI, and the performance. Thank you. You know that we will launch our Mate 30 series smartphone in 2 weeks later in Munich, in the 16th of this month. And this flagship phone will embed this Kirin 990 and the Kirin 990 5G. So welcome you to join this launch event in Munich. Thank you. Today, we are living in a connected world. We are connected by the smartphone, but also by the wearable devices, by the earpieces. You know, today I also want to bring some new chips, our new chips for connecting, for hyper connecting people. And you can use these chips for in the earpieces, your Bluetooth earpieces, in a smart watch or even smart wear. So this is our Kirin A1. The Kirin A1 is the world's first Bluetooth 5.1 and a Bluetooth low energy 5.1 support wearable chips. Inside this, we have the processor, app processor, and a Bluetooth connection, the sensor hub, all this technology, and the power management, all this inside this. And this chip is very small, very tiny. It's much smaller than this one, than this Kirin 990. It's too small to take. It's a very small and a tiny size. It can put in the earpieces, occupy less space. And we are leading in the performance technology. You can see that, so we are using a very innovative isochronous dual channel Bluetooth connection technology. You see the industry, the other chips, they are using the one earpieces for relay. That means some longer latency, more latency, but more higher power consumption. The Apple's their solution is using simultaneously to left and right to transmit dual left and right channel. But it's less power, less latency, but it's more higher power consumption. Our solution, you can see this. Left and right transmission simultaneously, but if you are only left and right, so less power consumption, lower latency. So you have the best performing and a low latency, low power consumption. And you see that these chips also have the industry leading performance of anti-interference. in half hour, especially in the public area, a lot of inference. I give make a comparison with others. In half hour, the other chips meet 100 inference. And we, Kirin A1, only have 2, so much less than the others. Apple's, their H1 chips, they also have good performance. The Apple 2 they're using, so also less inference. So yeah, we have the industry leading level anti-inference. And also we are the industry's fastest Bluetooth transmission speed we can achieve. 3 times faster speed than the others. You can achieve the 6.5 megabit per second real-time transmit speed. And in this way, you can support the ultra-high definition audio for better sound. We can achieve the 2.3 megabit per second Bluetooth UHD speed. And using these chips, you can use them for true wireless audio earpieces, and for headset, for your necklace, and even for your smartware, and even for your smartwatch, you can use this Kirin A1 chips. Today, I bring a new product which is using these Kirin A1 chips. I show you that it's in my pocket. I have 2. I bring 2 color for your selection. And this is a. This is a FreeBuds 3. So this front and this back front, you can see this. It's a very, very innovative product. It's the best performing true wireless earpieces in the world. Who take it away? Okay, this, you can see. So it's really, really the tiny size, and this FreeBuds 3, we have the aesthetic design and the intelligent noise cancellation. That's very unique, very big difference with others, and also ultimate performance we can bring. So let's first look at our design. You know, this design of this, we are pure symmetrical aesthetic design. It's a very simple, but a very symbolic. And also, it's an open fit earbuds. You can see the open fit earbuds and with ergonomic curvature. So you can see a very comfortable fit in your ears. And also, the design of this shape, we are using we call it the dolphin vocal cavity. It's fitting your ear very comfortable, but also have the best sound quality. It's a very, very unique design. And also, you know, this is the pure design and also high glossy. This design of this shape is very unique. It's like a pebble. In your hand, it's very comfortable in your hand, but very light. So it's a symbolic design. And also, this more important, this brings you intelligence noise cancellation. You know that today we are living in a world with a lot of noise, in the railway and in the subway, in the public area, a lot of noise, in the airplane, and also when you're traveling. When you're listening to music, a lot of noise is a very really headache things. But how can we make you to listening to make a phone call quietly? We want to live in a quiet world. So with this one, have the noise cancellation. This is the world's first open fit earpieces which have active noise cancellation. You know that if you do the active noise cancellation on in-ear pieces is easy to do, but the open fit is very difficult to do the noise cancellation, but we achieve this. You know that with our adaptive noise cancellation, you can tune in to check to the different, you know, different people have different size, on the different shape of your ear candles. So that by the change to the best for your ears, you can achieve the up to 15 dB the noise, ambient noise reduction. And also we have, not only we have the downlink, the noise cancellation, but we also have leading uplink noise cancellation. We have three microphone and also we have the bone sensor inside to help to cancellation the your uplink the noise, not only the downlink noise. The uplink is when you make a phone call. And more important, more than this, we also have introducing the new architecture, the new design for we call it our patented aerodynamic micro duct. When the wind is outside, have wind. So in this architecture, we can avoid the wind go to the microphone. So this is a very smart design. Our patent design, our micro duct to defeat the wind and wind when you make a phone call, especially when you make a phone call outside, the wind in your outdoor environment, or you take a scooter in Germany, now it's outside, when you scooter and a bicycle. When you make a phone call during that time, you have less noise. How it works? Let's make a record a video audio to show you. Because when the high speed, when you're outside, the windy, you can see that, you can listen to that.
Welcome to the IFA 2019 in Berlin.
So you can see that in a windy environment, so the FreeBuds 3 have much better phone call quality. The crystal clear conversation, even on the windy area, on the moving, when you're driving, taking a bicycle, 20 kilometers hour per kilometer per hour, even high speed. And also the FreeBuds 3, you know, compared with the other the industry leading AirPods 2, and we have even better performing with our noise cancellation, active noise cancellation, with our anti-wind design, and also our bone sensor and three microphone for noise cancellation. We're creating a quiet world for you. And also, this also brings the best performance. You can see the inside the architecture design. And we are using a 7 millimeter high sensitivity dynamic driver with a dedicated bass tube inside. So the sound quality is impressive. When you're listening to music, the bass, especially the bass. And also, they achieved a lower, much lower latency. It's working with a Huawei smartphone. You can see the only 190 milliseconds. It's much lower than all the industry, the others. The AirPods 2, they also have very good performance, but our performance latency even lower than them. So much lower than the others. Especially for the mobile gaming, lower latency for the audio is better performing for you play the game. And also it's about much faster speed charging. And while charging, we are 100% faster than AirPods 2. And while it's charging, also 50% faster. So happy to charging this is more conveniently. And also have long lasting battery, 4 hours for just one charge, 20 hours totally in this, because you have battery inside this case. So ladies and gentlemen, this is a Huawei FreeBuds 3, the best wireless, true wireless audio headset in the world. You have the best audio quality, best noise cancellation, and also super fast charging. All the. You know, today, I also want to bring you some, not only today we are living in a connected world, connecting people, but I'd like today to bring you something which is connecting your home. How can you connect your home intelligently? Today, at your home, we are mainly using the Wi-Fi for the home connection. I bring some solution to show you. But you know, today at home, the connection, the biggest issue for the connecting of the home is the Wi-Fi. If you have a large home, a large house, and always to meet the weak Wi-Fi signal area, the problem. And also sometimes you can install more AP in your at home, but the problem, the more AP that each AP have their SSID, that means you will switch between the AP. That's not convenient. A lot of problem. I know some people they are using the Wi-Fi relay for improve the coverage in your big house, but that's will speed not fast because the relay will reduce the speed. But our solution is here. This is a Huawei Q2 Pro. We connected without boundary with a new solution. And how about this? This is a big one. And you can use the satellite one for better coverage. So it's a plug and play. It's a very convenient to use. So I assure you that at your home, maybe you have in your big house, you have multi rooms. If some room you have don't good coverage, you can plug in this there. Any area, just plug in. How can you connect between this? They are using the power line connection, PLC, power line connection. So it's very convenient. Just plug and play. No matter how big your house, you always can have the best connectivity. But if you have the Ethernet cable, you also can connect here. But even you don't have the in that room have the Ethernet cable, you just power line. Using a power line connect with this. So that's really very convenient. And also between that, using same ID, same SSID, the same Wi-Fi, it looks like the same Wi-Fi. It's automatic roaming. Switching between the between that is only less than 100 milliseconds. It's very, very, very fast, very convenient. And also it's very easy to add new satellite. You just press this button, then you plug in. Then it's automatically, this red light will be becoming green. That means connected. So just plug and play. So really, it's the maximum we can support 15 satellites. So that's no matter how big a house you have, you always can have the best coverage, the best performance. It's a plug and play, simple, easy to use. You know that we are proud of our performance. Our performance, we are using the 3-line. You can see this. Not only this is the 2 AC power line, but also you're using the earth line for higher speed. By this together, we can support 200 megabit per second speed. The industry, the other level, the only maximum, they only can support 100 megabit. But with these 3 line together, we can support 200 megabit per second. This is really, really super much faster speed. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Wi-Fi, Huawei Wi-Fi Q2, a connector without boundary. You know, that's we start to ship this in Europe. We already ship this in China. It's very good consumer feedback. Now we bring this innovative product to European market, to global market. Thank you.
A phone, can you bring to me?
Okay. You know, that's in the spring of this year in Paris, we launched the Huawei P30 series smartphone. It's becoming the most popular P series ever. And for just 6 months, half a year, globally, we sold out over 16.5 million P30 series smartphone globally. We achieved 53% growth. You know that we win a lot of the best smartphone award. We win over several hundred best smartphone award globally. So that's including the best European best by Acer, the best European smartphone, and also by the TIPA as the best smartphone camera, and a lot of award globally. You know that this P30 series smartphone, we set the industry the new benchmark for smartphone photography and performance. And you know, the phone's design, you remember that our aesthetic design, our conic design. And also we bring the very unique gradient colors on the phones, on the P30 series. It's an amazing color. It's received very good consumer feedback globally. And also, this phone also set the new form and the new color trend for this industry. I give an example to show you why it's like that. For example, that's when we launch this product, the industry, the other phones like this. But now, you can see, they changed it. They changed it to the new one. So we're leading the industry trend, okay? So we're leading the industry's design the chain of flagship phones. Okay. You know, today I want to bring a new P30 Pro. Let's see our design concept. Our design inspired by nature, the sea, the sky, and the sea. You can see the infinity duality. There is look together. So that today I bring our new phone, new P30 Pro. This is a very unique design. You see that's this is back side. Okay, and the inside I show you the front. So inside outside is matched together. All this design. You know that's this color is a mystique blue. You know, it's like the evening of the sea. You can see the sky and the sea, and that's very unique, okay. And also, we bring the themes to match with inside, outside, okay. And this is a misty lavender. The misty lavender, this color is also unique. So this one. And also, you can see that inside this this one also match with the outside. You can see that. And also, we are the technology for this is very interesting. For this, we are using this glossy. It shows the beauty of this camera and this front part. But also, here is matte. You can see no fingerprint on it at all. No fingerprint on this mat, so your hand held it. It's comfortable, and not slippery. Sleepy, but also but more comfortable to hold. But also is most beautiful. So this with this, you know that's our P30 series phone that are leading the mobile photography. And on this phone, we have the industry first sensor. We're using RYYB. The red, yellow, blue, that sensor is a very unique sensor, which can increase 40% more in light, more light intake. But more importantly, we are using the industry, the largest sensor, the 125 times larger than the others, even than the other phones, the latest phones, latest Note 10 Plus. Our sensor is also much bigger, 125 times bigger than them. But together with RYAB, these two technologies together, and also with ultra large aperture of this lens together, so we can achieve the industry leading ISO over 400,000 ISO. So that's the industry is really amazing ISO for low light quality is the best. So. You know, I show you that the comparison of this photography, even up to today, that's the new phones, half a year later, the new phones, the single shot the low light condition, you can see the photo's capability. We still the best performing smartphone, the camera, best camera. Even the long exposure in the desert, you can see that. Compared with the other phone, you can see that. They have some, they improve a lot, a little bit, but it's still have big gap with us, right? This beautiful photo is taken by Huawei, our global P30 series owners. You can see that so beautiful photo taken by. All those photos are taken by our global P30 series users. You know, this phone has the industry leading periscope lens, which can maximum support 50 times digital room, optical room 5 times, hybrid room 10 times, and digital room 50 times. You see that make comparison with other 10 times zoom in low light, you can see the detail. So good quality, you enlarge that for far away for 10 times. You can see that. And also the photo is taken also by the consumer 6 times, 5 times zoom by the P30 owners globally. And all this, you can see is from take the bird's photo from far away, 10 times, and the animal, you can see that. How good quality. And also this time that we are also using our new software to upgrade the P30 series smartphone to the new color system to make it more vivid color on this P30 series. The new P30 Pro and all the existing P30 will be upgrade the photography technology by software. Also bring your super night selfie with the AI processor. You can the background processing. You can see the segment of the girl with the background. You take a selfie. You can take a very clear photo, no matter the front, but also back. You see this phone, they also can take the photo is okay, but the background is blurred. The detail, lost the detail. If you see that one, on the rooftop, you can see that the detail all very clear. Even the character, you can see this girl's background, the character, all very clear. You can see this our AI processing on the camera technology. We can make it both. It's very good quality. So, and this phone, running the EMUI 10, we upgrade this phone P30 series to EMUI 10, which supports Android 10, the latest Android 10. So what's Android 10? Let's have a video to show you. You can see that from this video that we use a new UX design, UI design by the, including the magazine layout, including the new color, the Morandi color, and some very, very, very interesting things. And also we improve the UI to make it fluently operation interaction between the consumers. And also we're introducing the dark mode to cover more scenario. The dark mode is not only protect your eyes, to make your eyes more comfortable, you see the screen, but much lower power consumption for the phones. Because of this phone, the P30 series, we are using the OLED display. OLED display in the display the dark, much lower power consumption, lower end, make the phone's battery life longer. So it's with this dark mode. So this dark mode can cover more scenario. And also we have very innovative design. It's unbelievable design. You make your P30 phones closer to your MateBook PC. Then your phone can go inside your PC, looks like that. You can operate your phones in your PC. That's unbelievable. You can use the keyboard of the PC for input, and all the phones, it looks like your phone went into your PC, your screen, and your camera, and your keyboard, and all the operation. You can operate your phones in the PC. The screen is your phone screen. Even can you're into working, you can your phone, your PC's apps, you can draw your apps from here to there. You draw a photo from here to there to your. It's very convenient in working. So this it's a very unique design, very innovative design. So make the intelligent cross-platform interaction. That we are the only one to invent this idea. No other can do that. So it's very, very unique. You can try this experience. It's really bring a lot more convenience for you. When I using the phones, I can use the big screen for the PC screen, PC for this operation of this phone. So this in the working as bring much more efficiency to everyone. You know, on Android 10, and they have also have the gesture, but we already support over 1 year ago, from last year, May 20, we already support the gesture. Recently, the Android 10, they also introduced this, but we already support this, so there's no new. So we have a lot of enhanced functionality to improvement on the EMUI 10. Please experience this by yourself. And also, you know, on the P30 series, we have 5 color for your selection, together with these 2 new color. So totally we have 5 color for your selection. And the EMUI 10 running with all Android 10, we will better access from this month. So large volume, the global subscribers can use maybe from November maybe. But the better time, better access maybe from this month. So this new color, the new P30 Pro will be available from 20th of this month. This is our new P30 Pro. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your coming. And this is a product today we launch. Please enjoy to our demo in our booth in Hall 6. Thank you. Thank you. Ich will nicht wissen, was du machst, wenn du high bist. Ich häng besoffen ab in irgendwelchen Bars und ich merke, dass ich ohne dich allein bin. Augenringe spiegeln sich in meinem Glas. Ich hab dich gehen lassen wie ein Feigling. Und ich warte auf ein Signal, nur noch ein letztes Mal, noch das Ende.